Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can adjust the time and location of photos in the Photos app on your Mac. So when you take a picture with your iPhone or another camera, it will add to the metadata of the file the time and also the location if it's available. For instance, your iPhone probably knows your location using its GPS ability, but a regular camera may not have that, so there may be no location information. But sometimes this information is inaccurate. For instance, you may have changed time zones but not changed the clock on your camera to reflect that. Here's how you can change the time and also location on any photo. So as an example, let's use this photo here. If I go into it, I could see at the top, it's got a date and time, and it also has a location here. But let's say I want to change the time, because perhaps it's wrong. Perhaps I had the time zone wrong or something. You can go into image, and then here is where you adjust date and time. Select that, and now you have all of these controls here. In most cases, what you probably want to do is change the time zone. To do that, just search for a location near where you were. So you just type the name of a location. It doesn't have to be the exact location, just something in the same time zone. So I'll adjust it with this, and you could see here, just by pressing tab to accept this field here, it adjusts the time, you see, by 2 hours. The original is shown here and the adjusted time is there. If I click adjust here, now you can see the time has changed up here. I can always go back in and see the original time like that and change the time zone back to anything else I want, like that. You could also click on the map to easily jump to a specific time zone. Now, in addition to that, you can simply change the time here and leave the time zone alone. So if perhaps the clock on your camera wasn't set correctly, you can change something here. I'll change this to 9 p.m. here and adjust, and you can see it's changed there. And I could go back here. I could always see the original time to go back to it. The original time, the actual metadata of the photo, never changes. It's always there. That's because Photos is non-destructive with your original file. Whatever the camera gave to Photos, that metadata is always going to remain there. So if you had the wrong time as your original time, it will always stay as the original time. You always could know what that original data looked like. But by adjusting it here in Photos, when you search for things by date or you look at a list and it's sorted by date, it's always going to use the adjusted time. So you can kind of forget that the original time was wrong, but the original file doesn't get altered. It's very important. Photos will not alter the original file. You want to always be able to go back to the original if for some reason you need to. Now, this also works in batches. You can select multiple photos, like I'll select these four here, and then I could go to adjust date and time, and it will say here at the top, it's going to adjust the date and time of four selected photos. And if you do something like change the time zone or change the time, say increasing the time here by 1 hour, then it's going to adjust all of the photos by that 1 hour. It won't set them all to this exact time. It's going to move them all the same amount of time. So it's easy to select a group of photos and correct the time in them all at once. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You could read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, how about location? You can see the location of all your photos by going to the map here. And it'll show you the map and you can zoom in and it'll break it into smaller groups and everything like that. It will only show photos here that actually have a GPS location set. However, if you want to adjust the location of a photo because it's wrong, you go to that photo. In the menu, there is location. We'll look at that in a minute. But if you want to set the location manually for something, like change this one, what you would do is click the I button here, the info button, or just use window info or command I. It brings up the info window with all sorts of metadata shown and a map showing you the location. You can move around on this map and zoom in and zoom out. But to change it, what you need to do is click and hold the little pin. You can't just simply drag it. You have to click and hold, wait for it to be lifted up, then move it to a new location like this and drop it there. And it will drop and now have that adjusted location right there. But you can also type. So, for instance, I can type the name of a city or a specific location or even an address and select it, and it will move to that spot. This is really handy for when you don't know the exact location, and you just want to type the name of the city to at least have it be closer to the actual location. There are tons of locations you can type in addition to a regular address that it will recognize. So notice here I've changed this location, but remember, the metadata of the original photo is always preserved. That original file is exactly the same way it was when it came off the camera. So if I go to image here and location, you see I've got revert to original location here, and now this photo has reverted to that spot. Now what about situations where there is no location? For instance, if I view this photo here, you'll see there's no location up here. I took this with a regular camera, something that didn't have GPS, so it doesn't have a GPS location there. If I click the info button here or use Command I, I can see there's no location, but I can assign a location. To do that, you can just type something like that. Unless you do know the exact location, it's okay to have something vague like this. At least now it'll appear on the map correctly and appear in searches correctly. But once you've got a map going here like this, you can adjust it here. I'll go ahead and move this somewhere closer to the actual location like that. And you can revert this to the original location, which in this case is nothing. There is another way to set the location. Say you took a picture with your iPhone near or maybe exactly the same location as you took a picture with the regular camera. So, for instance, I could go to this photo here, to selfie, and it was taken with my iPhone. It's got a location here. So I go to image location, and I could copy this location. And now I could go to this photo here, and I can go to image location and assign location. And it will assign the same location as from the one that I copied. So that's super handy. If you are taking a whole bunch of photos with a regular camera and you know you're not going to get GPS information, take one picture with your iPhone just to grab that GPS location later, and you can assign it to all the photos. You can do just like you did with time, where you can select a range of photos here. You can get info, and you'll see all the pins here. You can't move the pins since they're multiple ones, but you can type here to assign a location to all of them. So here's some extra tips. If you go to View and then Metadata and turn on Location, you'll see this little GPS symbol in the top right corner of any photo that has a location assigned. So I could see very easily which photos have a GPS location and which photos don't. And also, I can click on this and it will go right to the info window here. If you want to remove the location from a photo, like this one, you can go to Image Location and then Hide Location. And you can see it no longer shows the location here. But like I said before, the original is always retained. So you can always go to Image Location and revert to original location and it will show it again. And notice by having View Metadata Location on, I also see the little symbol here in this view, and I can click on it to get info. When exporting a photo like this one, I'll export one photo like that. I have the option to turn off location information. So the exported version will not have the location. Sometimes that's important for uploading to websites, so there's a little privacy protection. But if you do export with location, note that if you've modified the location, like I have with this photo here, if I go to File, Export, and then use regular export like that, include the location information, but then I'll also export the unmodified original like this. Now I've got these two different versions here. If I open them both up in preview, I can note that if I look at the info here and look at the GPS information, that this one shows me the modified location, but this one will show me the original location, not the modified one, because we asked for the original unmodified photo to be exported. So you always are going to get back the exact file that your camera produced. So that's how you adjust the date and time and location of photos in the Photos app. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.